It was the summer of my senior year in high school, and my friends and I decided to do a trip to our local zoo. And since I was the oldest of the friends, and the only one with a car and driver's license, I was, volunteered to be the driver. Now, I don't want to reveal my age or anything, so let's just say that none of us at that time owned a smartphone. So instead of relying on Siri for directions, we had to go to a website called MapQuest and print out the directions. And one of us had to volunteer to read the directions aloud. So anyways, we printed out the directions, followed them to the zoo, and arrived in excellent time. We spent the day doing the whole zoo thing until it was finally time to go home. As we were leaving the park that afternoon, I asked my friends to give me the printed MapQuest directions. But in a not-so-surprising turn of events, none of my friends knew where the directions were. But that was okay. My friends were confident they could navigate us back home based on their superior memory. So, putting my trust in my friends, we drove off, going in what we believed was the right direction. After an hour of driving, however, my friends' collective confidence slowly wore off, and it was clear we were lost. You see, my friends each had an idea of where we needed to go, but none of them had a full picture of our journey home. Had we just kept the MapQuest directions, our trip home could have been much, much easier. In Helaman chapter 12, the prophet historian Mormon tells us that the Nephites were going through one of their many, many, many rebellious phases. In verse 6, Mormon identifies one of the root problems that lead the Nephites to rebel. Behold, the Nephites do not desire that the Lord their God, who hath created them, should rule and reign over them. Notwithstanding his goodness and his mercy toward them, they do set at naught his counsels, and they will not that he should be their guide. So here's an application question for you. Who do we choose for our guides? On our journey through life, there are many potential guides offering us direction. Some guides are excellent, while other guides are, well, less so. Like my friends leading me to and fro with their pieced together memory, there are some guides who have shards of truth, but don't have the full picture of the plan that God has for our lives. There are some who are even so confident in their misguided directions that if we are not careful, we can get led down strange roads and forbidden paths. Here are two questions to ponder. 1. Who or what are some of the guides in our lives that are eager to lead us down strange roads and forbidden paths? And 2. Who or what are the guides in our lives that we can trust to lead us back to our heavenly home? For me, much like those printed MapQuest directions, it is my testimony that the printed words of the scriptures provide the guidance I need to lead me through this life. I have faith in the promise found in 1 Nephi chapter 15. Whoso would hearken unto the word of God and would hold fast unto it, they would never perish. Neither could the temptations and the fiery darts of the adversary overpower them unto blindness, to lead them away to destruction. It is my testimony that if we hold fast to the word of God and live by the teachings found in the scriptures, we will not be led away to destruction. Rather, we will be led down the path that leads us ultimately back home. As always, thank you guys for watching. My goal is to create inspiring and uplifting content during this crazy time. If you want to see more videos like this, you can watch my last video here, and you can subscribe to my channel. And hopefully I will see you next time.